Good morning, friends. I hope your weekend has started well. Now, today I'm going to discuss a very interesting technique. And what is interesting about it, that it goes against the grain of what, you know, most of us are being told, which may not be necessarily incorrect, but you know, it's not in keeping with the structure of the market. Now, let me go to my whiteboard and try to tell you what I am talking about. Okay, lots of us are being told on a daily basis that this is your support, this is your resistance, buy above, buy above this level and sell below this level. Okay, now what is the trouble I have with this? Today, you know, the market is being traded by machines, and anybody who does not know or understand that is, in my view, a novice. Now, what are the machines instructed to do? The machines are instructed to trap the biggest amount of people on one side. Okay. And they generally do it in the direction of the trend. So if you are in a daily uptrend, which we are in, the moment, you know, say this is one day's worth of trading, this is the next day's worth of trading. So the moment you break below a previous low, lots of people get short. Okay, now 8 times out of 10, what is happening is that, you know, the market goes down a bit and then it starts to find support and the follow through is missing. So around this zone in a daily uptrend, when you break down below a previous day's low, if you start to see the bears getting trapped, often the bigger opportunity is on the upside. Similarly, in a downtrend, if the market starts to trade above a previous day's high, again, people are more likely to get trapped here and the market is likely to come off. So, in a sense, what is the bigger odds today? Because, you know, the traditional resistance support has no value. Once the machines get on board, they basically roger you on the upside. So my premise is that once you have determined that you are in some sort of an uptrend, so on any time frame, on an intraday time frame, wait for a previous day's low to be broken on the downside. Okay. And then wait for it to play out. Now, sometimes you will have the market going and closing at the lows of the day. But 8 times out of 10, what is happening is that the market starts to fail on the downside and starts to go higher. And this you will only know with observation. So in an uptrending market, if for any event or because of any reason, you are opening below the low of the day or going below the low of the day, the market is setting up an opportunity. We'll go through several examples. Now, this is true for market trading below one day's low. Okay, day low, month low, week low, sorry. And monthly low, if it comes to that. But since we are talking more in the context of day trading and swing trading, below a previous day's low, I think 80% of the time, the market tends to reverse. And the reason is that most traditional technical analysis tends to work on follow through. And these days, with the amount of futures and options that is being done, you know, most of the time there are traps which are being set up. Okay, if we are in an uptrend and if we go below day's high, then there is no game for you. Now, this sort of market will set up maybe 2-3 times a week, but it does set up and it gives you the opportunity to take the other side and which creates large moves. Okay, so now let's go and check out some of the examples. Now, on the examples, let's start with the Nifty chart, and then we'll see even on the Bank Nifty. Now, this is the 15-minute chart of the Nifty. Okay, we can check out on the 5-minute also. Now, 23rd of July, this was the low, 11,108. 24th of July, we broke the 11,108 zone around here. Okay. Now, as an intraday trader who is trying to use this particular strategy, the market broke yesterday's low, you watched, made a high, then again came back, made a low. Now, this low was higher than the previous low. So, what is happening here? These guys are getting trapped. Okay. Now, was it possible that the market kept on going lower? That was possible, but 8 times out of 10, what we are observing is that the market does not show follow through against the trend. Now let me go to another example. This is 21st of July. Okay. Here the low is again 11,110. Okay, somewhere around this zone on 22nd of July, we started to move below previous day low. This was the action which happened below previous day low. Again, you can see that in this zone, people are getting trapped. Okay. How do you know they are trapped? Once you start to see these big green bars. So you get on the alert mode the moment a previous day low is broken, and then you start observing. I am not saying this will work all the time, but this will work 80% of the time. Okay. Again, what if you don't go below previous day low? Then you are not in business, in my opinion. Like, on this kind of a day, the previous day low is way lower. So you are not in business. Okay. Again, you are not at previous day low. So you are not in business. Here, what happened, the market came down. I think we need to change our scale. We need to put our scale according to the exchange. Okay. So here, this was the low on the 15th. Next day, you opened on the 16th, retested this low, and the market began to head up. So while it is possible to do this below previous day's low, even if there is a retest, this strategy is on. And the benefit is that you can carry to the next day. So it can become even a swing entry. Now let's look at what will happen on a weekly chart. Now, on a weekly chart, let me show you an example which happened very recently. Now, look at this day, this week. This week, we went below the previous week's low and immediately bounced back and had a 400 point rally. Have a look at this week. We went below previous week's low and immediately we closed higher, and next week again we were higher. So what the market is doing is it tends to go below key zones, gets people short, and then resumes in the direction of the trend. So in my view, going with this strategy of going short on the break of previous day low or on the break of previous day high is a silly strategy. A much better strategy is trying to act on the other side. If the market in an uptrend is breaking a previous day's low and is not showing follow through. Now, let me not act as if it works all the time. There will be times when the market breaks previous day low and goes and closes at the low point of the day. Now, look here. On 14th of July, market opened below previous day's low. At no point did it make a higher low, and it closed at the lowest point of the day almost. So there will be days like this when there is no failure, and you know, you'll get to know when there is no failure because a higher low needs to be formed. So on such days, I don't think you have any business to do, and you sit quiet and you know, just watch. Okay. So what do you have to do? Identify trend up or down. Once the trend is identified, next is wait for the previous day low to get broken. Okay. And once that is done, you basically have to watch for a failure. Okay, now let's have a look at this sort of day. You opened at 9:30. Okay. The low was made at 2 o'clock. Now next day we went below this 2 o'clock low. We went lower and lower, and the bears thought they had it. Somewhere around here, we started to see a lot of green bars. So when this sort of action starts to happen, this red bar was taken out by green bar. So immediately you know that some sort of trap is being set up. And from there, you had a rally which kept going and going, and even on the next day, you got some. So if I have to tell you a very simple technique, it is that wait for a previous day low or a previous day high to be broken in an uptrend or a downtrend respectively, and then look for a failure. What is happening these days is that markets are not showing you great amount of follow through against the trend. And when it does show follow through, stand on the sideline. There will be days when the market keeps going lower. On those days, you have no business. So what we are going to do business in case below a previous day low, the market starts to fail. If we have some extra confirmation like some average 20-day moving average, etc., which is here, you know, that will create a swing low. So even on a swing basis, these techniques can be used. But on an intraday basis, every day you get below the low of previous day, you have an opportunity which is setting up. The opposite is valid in a downtrend. Now let me see if these things are valid on the Bank Nifty, where lots of you are interested. So this is the Bank Nifty. See, Bank Nifty, what happens is that it tends to increase speed as it breaks a previous day low. And lots of people get positioned on the other side once the previous day low breaks. And after that, you are looking for it to set up. Okay, so look at certain examples. Now, this is 21st of July. The low of this day was about 22,500. Next day we open and the Bank Nifty almost went as low as the previous day's low. Let me open a 15-minute chart so that you can see better. So this was one day's low. Okay, next day the Bank Nifty almost came down and touched the previous day low. So that is where your trade starts to set up. Okay, let's go back further and see more examples. Now this day's low, which was 14th of July, was 21,250 thereabouts. Next day on 15th of July, we went below this low on 14th of July. So obviously something got triggered. And the moment on 16th of July, there was a failure to make a fresh low, the upside trade began to set up. Now to look at this red bar, how many bears got short here? So you have to take one side in the direction of the 20-day moving average, wait for the low to get broken and you know the bears to come in strongly, and then look for failure. I think this is a technique which has an advantage, that what you are looking for is the market to break certain lows. Now what will happen on a day like this? On the 10th of July, you opened lower and kept on going lower. Bad luck. On 13th of July, you broke previous day low and you kept on going. This is not your game. On 14th of July, you went down and kept going lower. On 15th of July, again, you made a fresh low, and that is where the failure started to set up. So it need not be 1 day low, it could be 2 day low, 3 day low, but what you are watching out for is the market to fail at a previous day low. Okay. Now, yes, it requires certain amount of practice, and mostly it requires patience, because if you are not patient and you jump in, you will get into trouble. Okay. So identify the day's low beforehand. You are not going to take the other side if the high gets broken. In an uptrend, you will always work on the low. Okay. So that way, what you are doing is that as and when the market sets up a trap, like this is a day where you opened below previous day low and you started to go lower. For possibly the next hour or so, the market started to fail. And that is where the opportunity came for you to take the other side. Where is your stop? The stop is the current day's low. Okay. That is the whole bet, that you are not going to take. You are expecting that the market will not make a fresh low. So I hope this clarifies a situation. This is a technique that if you practice, you will not need to do much else. Generally, this technique will work the best when there is negative global news or local news to start with. You break a previous day's low and the market fails to go lower. I think that should be the gist of this video. This can work on individual stocks also, but on individuals I will be more careful, because they tend to trend more, and I would like to have a confirmation of a 20 day moving average or some moving average support to look for price failure. But on a index basis, I think it works a lot of time. Every couple of days, it tends to work. So, you know, this is a very handy technique. When will this not work? When the market starts to trend. Okay. And in a trending market, the first day will be a failure day. So even in that case, it will tend to get you in the swing. Like here, you had these failure days and they got you in for this sort of swing. Okay, because in a swing, obviously your lows are higher. But on the days when you get a lower low, try to watch for a market which is failing at lower levels. That will set up the best 2-3 day type of trade, and even on an intraday basis, it will set you up for a good trade. The more confirmation you have in terms of averages, in terms of support, etc., the better off you will be. That should be it. Take care, trade well, and please consult your financial advisor.